And I think one of the most exclusive components of space technology in the last 10 years under Prime Minister Modi has been that it was no longer limited only to the launching of rockets. I vividly remember, I think it was the year 2015, when Dr. Radhakrishnan was the chairman. We had a 2-3 day long marathon brainstorming in Vigyan Bhavan, where space scientists were made to interact with the representatives of each ministry so that they could share where in the space technology could step in. And I think that's proved to be a role model for the rest of the world also, because we have so many sectors, so diverse, so heterogeneous, which no other country has. And therefore today, space technology is enriching our work in fisheries, in agriculture. The soil health card, the Swamitva program, which has almost become a role model for the rest of the world. In disaster monitoring, in natural resource monitoring, in railways, the unmanned rail crossings, in the construction of highways, the construction of smart cities, education, healthcare, you name a sector, and India has shown the rest of the world how space technology can improve our performance. And before I conclude, for the benefit of those, because as I was saying yesterday during one of the discussions, after Chandrayaan, space technology has fascinated every Indian. And many of those who may not have a direct stake in space sector, many of them who may not be interested, but since they feel a sense of esteem, they feel a sense of pride, they look at India can do it. India can lead the rest of the world. And for the benefit of those, because as students of science fraternity, we've been taught not to speak without evidence. India was the first to reach the Mars in the first attempt. India, as I said a few moments ago, through Chandrayaan, was the first to reach the South Pole of Moon. India is the second to have an X-ray polarization satellite. And India, a few months ago, was the third to have a solar observatory, the Sun-Earth L-length point, the Aditya. And therefore, I have the confidence to say, when we talk of India 2047 and India reaching that pedestal, when we try to scientifically analyze how it would happen, where the value addition will come from, the value addition will come from those sectors which were hitherto either unexplored or underexplored. Hamare wo sarmaye jo na puri tarah tarashege na talashege, aur Modi ji ki prerna se us taraf hamari nigaah gayi. And one of them is going to be the space sector. And I'm proud to declare this morning, ladies and gentlemen, with Chairman ISRO as a witness, that in 2047, space sector will be an important component writing the growth story of Viksit Bharat. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.